Podge, the show for people who abso-feckin-lutely don't get up early in the mornings.
That's right.
Sure, if we were on any later, we'd be breakfast telly.
That's right, and here she is, though we still don't really know what she is. It's Dear Gary!
Women will always be a mystery to you two little beasts.
Oh, no, no, not at all. No. Since we got the internet, we understand women much more.
Yeah, like they've no hair down there anymore.
No, they don't.
And they've got feelings.
Yes, yeah, feelings? What the fuck were you watching?
A Star Is Porn.
Ah.
Oh, it's a real heartbreaker. Lady Gaga for it. And Bradley Cooper. Amazing.
Okay, I'm not only the one to say this, but let's get out a guest. Right, whether she's bloated or beach beautiful, dumped or hopelessly in love, we're all hooked on the soap opera of her life. It's Dramarama Queen, Kerry Katona.
You are looking fantastic.
Have you been Specsavers?
Yeah, well, no, you do. Yeah,
no, you're looking gorgeous now.
You're fantastic.
From Queen of the Jungle to star of the Daily Mail sidebar of shame, Kerry. You're the tabloid gift that keeps on giving, but how the hell are you?
I'm really well, really good.
You were our favourite Atomic Kitten.
Oh, good.
Well, to be fair now, you're the only one that anyone can remember, but never mind that. Never mind that. Never
That's
mind.
That's true.
But look, let's have a... It's true, it is
true. It is true, it is true.
Let's have a look at Bubonic Kitten's biggest hit. Back home Maybe there's... Wait a second.
Which one is you? hold on there, can you
hold
stop
on
that?
A second!
Hold on! Cut!
Cut!
Here,
cut.
Where's Kerry? Oh, Jesus, that's not the video.
Wait, that is... What?
It happens to me all the time
What
on
happened
Google.
There?
What happened
all
there?
The time.
Okay, listen, we'll get it right. Lads, do we have the video?
Have we got the one with Kerry in it?
Shocking. What happened there?
Now, look, okay.
Lads,
do we dare we? Third time lucky.
We'll give it another go.
Kerry, what do you reckon?
Kerry.
Third time lucky.
We'll go again.
Let's give it a go. Oh, there you are!
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Jesus, for that. Oh, thank goodness for that.
I think if you play the second version.
I'm running the phone again. There you are now.
There you are. So what happened there?
Did they cut you out of that and put some other bitch in?
Yeah, they did. They did. Well, I fell pregnant with Molly and
right.
I just wanted to be a mum.
Right.
And my vocals are the ones that is on the single
that
went to number
that
one.
Used.
But then Jenny the bitch joined
yes.
in
yeah,
and...
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No, no.
Oh, I can see the Daily Mail now. Yeah. I'm joking. No, she is a bitch.
Yeah.
She's really not. No, she is.
Yes,
that's my bipolar, sorry.
Yeah.
And they changed the video.
They just cut you out and put her in. But
yeah,
never mind.
She got up the duff.
I was up the duff, but I got my number one. I got Molly.
That's lovely. Now. But come here, is it fair to say, though, you can blame most of your life's troubles on Brian McFadden?
Huh? I could.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
In the same respect.
Yeah.
No, I couldn't.
No, you couldn't. Yeah, we're right.
We blame him for most things that go wrong for us.
Oh, yeah.
Aww.
Yeah, we do. Yeah. Like the kettle broke the other day. We went, feckin' McFadden.
Yeah.
How do we put this delicately?
I don't know, brother. Try.
Why did you marry the fat one from Westlife?
He made me laugh.
You fucking laugh at that anyway. Look at that.
Well, you're not just laughing at his hair, no.
No, I was madly in love with Brian.
Oh.
He was my knight. In all seriousness, was my knight in shining armour. He took me away from a world that was no good for me. And he gave me the life, respectively, that I have actually now. He kicked it off, really.
Oh, well, I suppose,
in fairness. He gave me two amazing children.
Yeah, well.
Now, listen, come here. You leapt from singing to TV, right?
Yeah.
How did you find yourself in the jungle in 2004?
I was down to Louis Walsh.
Oh,
that
right.
bastard. Another one we can blame.
Yeah, Brian didn't want me to do the jungle. He was really, really against it. And Louis was like, look, she needs to be working.
Right. Just do it.
Yeah, and he convinced Brian to let me do it, and I did it.
Was it good, crack? Like, did you enjoy it?
No.
Would you know what?
Starving.
Yeah.
Well, just, looking back on it, it was a great experience. Yeah. I'll never, ever be more proud of my TV career as I was.
Well, you became queen of the jungle, in fairness. Yeah, you won the bloody thing.
Yeah, the first one, yeah. Well, look, let's have a look at you eating something disgusting for the sake of TV rating. Yeah.
You're making it worse, Kay. Stop.
Stop it. What is Katie now?
Okay.
Oh, jeez. No, is that a live grub?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. Oh, do you know what? That must bring you right back to McFadden there.
I've had worse in my mouth.
Oh, Jesus.
Ew.
Fair play to you, though.
Mate, do you think you fare better on reality shows than you do in real life?
Probably, yeah. That's why I'm so desperate to get a reality TV show now, so my life seems normal.
Oh, right, I hear you.
But then would it be any crack? That's the thing.
Hey, it's always a good crack with me, love.
No, that's true.
I believe that.
You've had your ups and downs. We're not going to waste our time asking you about all the drugs.
We haven't got time.
Yeah.
We're not going to ask you about all the drugs you've taken, so let's just save time.
Like I said, we haven't got time.
I know, I'm going to save time by asking you, are there any drugs you haven't taken? You know? I mean, you got fired from the Iceland ad for snorting the ice.
I did. I know how unfair it is.
I was
promoting them.
You think so?
No, you
thought it was an advert in itself.
Yeah.
Snowing at Christmas and all that.
I know, yeah.
Now, come here, it all kind of turned to shit after that, didn't it?
It did, really.
You had the money troubles then after that and all kind of lost
I
all
did.
The deals and everything, you know?
I did, yeah.
Yeah. But here's the thing that we were thinking, and myself and the brother were thinking, right? You know... One minute you're claiming you're feckin' bankrupt, right? The next minute you're going out and buying yourself a new arse. One of them is supposed to be a Brazilian butt lift.
That is just a really great arse.
It is great arse. Oh, we're not contesting that fact.
No. But we're trying to figure out as which is the before and which is the after.
You're missing a trick. You could be cashing in on a new Irish tourist attraction, the new Ring of Kerry.
That's the thing, it's all about cashing in, you know.
I mean, think about it, Kerry.
And we can throw in a prom ring as well.
But listen to the thing about this. You could use some of the existing attractions that are already there.
There you are. There's Kerry's Ring of Kerry. So, let's visit Kerry's Gap of Dunlow. There it is.
Where next, you brother? Where next?
Well, why don't we visit the famous Ladies' View?
Ah, there it is. Where are we off to next?
We're going to slide over to the Skellig's Chocolate Factory.
Mmm, tasty.
The Skellig's Chocolate Factory.
And where will we go in the end, brother?
Well, why don't we head to Port McGee?
Ah, Port McGee.
You
could make a fortune.
Yeah, honestly, it sounds like a trip I want to go on.
It is. Oh, I'd love to go on it too.
I'd be driving the bus. Yeah.
Let's put this politely, Kerry. It must be hard. What?
It must be hard to get politely, is it?
I'm going to put it politely, I'm telling you.
Put it politely, honestly.
It must be hard to get parking outside your house on Father's Day. It's true. You know what it was?
I never knew my dad, so I just want to make sure there's enough dads involved for my kid.
But come here, you get...
If you lose one, you've got another one there.
You're right.
Now, listen, you spent a few decades with the paparazzi watching your every move.
Do you have to ring them in advance?
Only depending on the cut of the money.
Oh, right. I know what you mean. Like...
So if you said, you know, because they're always kind of catching in your bikini and stuff like that, you know. Mm. Do you start to ring
Well, that's
them up?
Where the money is.
Is that what it is? So
listen,
you say,
if I didn't lose weight and put it on, I wouldn't have a career.
Right, I know, I hear you.
Why do you think I get married and divorced?
Ah,
keep
true,
it popular.
Right. So you might say, listen, lads, I'm going to be on Bray Seafront at 1:30 in a blue polka dot bikini. Come down and take a photograph of me and I look like I don't think you're there or something. Is that how it works?
100%.
Right. Yeah. Or
because
I'm going to...
Yeah. Why? I have 5 children to feed.
Gotta feed them.
Can't
so that's
feed my
why
kids.
You'd make that call and you'd say, I'm gonna be lying on the tarmac outside the airport with my pants around my ankles.
That only happened a couple of weeks ago, right? Was that in protest of Ryanair's new luggage restrictions?
No, it's just me being pissed up.
Right, I hear you.
Fair enough.
It's obvious. Now, maybe I'm speaking out of turn here.
Where are we going? It's
obvious you haven't found the right man yet, Kerry.
Huh?
Do you think?
You've ended up another relationship with a toy boy. But listen to me now, listen to me. You just maybe need a more mature man. Perhaps a farmer with a homestead of his own and a servant or slave.
What? Where do you go with that? Oh, Jesus, where
Kerry,
do you go with this?
Get down here. Kerry, open that biscuit tin right there. Open it.
Oh, my God.
Right now, open it. It's happening. It's happening. Take it out, Kerry. Take it out. Kerry, looking back on when we first met 5 minutes ago, I cannot escape and I cannot forget. Kerry, you're the one. You still turn me on and I want to get me whole again. Kerry! Kerry! Shut up! Shut up, I'm kneeling! This is the big moment. Kerry Katona, would you do me the honour of being my missus?
Well, you're the best looking fella I've met so far. Absolutely.
Yes! Yes! It worked!
Wait a second! Wait a second!
It worked!
Wait a second, I thought we'd do everything together.
Well, I'm doing Kerry by myself. Pack your bags, Rodge. I'm in.
Shite.
Thanks so much, Kerry Katona, everybody!
Thanks, Kerry.
The happiest man alive, I am. The happiest man alive.
Okay, Darren, what's next?
What are you still doing here?
Well, I'm all excited to be meeting Ireland's funniest social media star, the James Kavanagh.
Oh, Jesus, that fella's just human clickbait.
Plus, there's a foot-stomping classic from trad punk Bowsy's Cronin.
Oh. Mm. Now, we like the sound of that. Mm.
See you after the break.
Yeah. Yes, you're back watching the Podge and Rodge show.
Yep, hashtag Podge and Rodge. That's what it says right there in the corner. Oh, Jesus Christ. You spelled the hashtag wrong. What is that?
I didn't spell it at all. It's a yoke.
Squiggle.
Hello, everybody.
Oh, that's better. Oh, there you are.
Hey. Now it's time to kick off my brilliant new beauty tutorial slot. Here it comes, everybody. I'm so excited to show you this.
What beauty tutorial? Listen, she's off her head.
Jesus, I think she's been at Kerry's meds.
Oh, beautiful. Okay, brows on fleek. Let's put them on there. Now, contoured chic, farmer chic, you could say. But you can live a happier life with my beautiful new product from the Please Don't Sue Me makeup range.
Jared, what are you doing? Seriously?
What's going on?
What's going on?
You asked me to impersonate a social influencer.
No. We asked you to introduce a social influencer. But if that's an accurate impression, we're having second thoughts, let me tell you. Not sure now.
Just get the fella out.
Okay. In the world of social media stars, he's the one the other social media stars call a total fluke. Gas is a vegan buffet and mental is a lentil. It's James Kavanagh.
James.
Hey.
How are you?
James Kavanagh!
Good.
Social media personality, whatever the shit in hell that is. Good man yourself.
That's me.
Now listen, if we were meeting you for the first time, James, what would you say your job is?
I would probably say I'm a fame addiction bitch.
Fame addiction bitch.
My name is James and I'm addicted to fame. That's
basically,
what you'd be saying.
Now, when he has proposed to Kerry, is the gay one going to propose to me?
I don't know, are you?
Well, just check. Is there a
ring? I do.
James, just check the box there. If there's another ring, fair play.
Oh, there is! Hey, babe.
Kerry, Fiona dumped me. She didn't even tell me.
I'm going to keep this on.
You can keep that.
You can keep it.
Come here, James, tell us this one. Did you have a bona fide real job before you started showing off and blathering about yourself?
I did. I worked in PR for 6 years.
Pretty good.
So I had a real job.
Yeah, but your brother has a real job as well, doesn't he?
He is a coach. Coach Cav. Yeah, he coaches Conor McGregor.
Right. That's a proper actual job, though. Proper real life job.
How on earth did your mad dad raise one son who trains Conor McGregor and another who runs an Instagram page for his cat?
Well, in fairness, they both work with pussies, to be fair.
Huh? Come on, you heard it, McGregor.
Come on, McGregor, you know you want to.
Come on, McGregor, you know you want to, come on. But seriously.
Pays the bills.
Yeah, no, but the two of you couldn't have picked more different careers. Do you get on or you're mortified by each other?
Well, I think you know, John went down the very hard man route. I went down the very, I don't know, this route.
No, come here. Tell us about your long-suffering partner, William.
I'm actually his first boyfriend. He was going out with girls before this.
Come here. He was going out with the girls before this.
Yeah. But no, we met on Grindr actually. It seems to always go back to Grindr.
Oh, you see,
for
that
some
settles that, because we thought you might have met over a game of Guess Who.
He's a spit of him. He's the spit of him.
Actual spit.
Yeah, actual spit of him.
He's got a real career though. He's a cook, isn't he?
He's a cook. Yeah, Ballymaloe trained.
Should he really have to put up with this kind of shit every day?
William. 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 William.
Oh Jesus.
William. 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 William.
Poor William.
Honest to God.
If your boyfriend or girlfriend scared that well, would you not scare them every moment of the day?
That went all over the YouTube on the Channel 4 and all that in the
UK. Did, and that's what launched me. Your man from RudeTube
came over,
interviewed us, and that's what kind of gave us a little platform. William being scared. He didn't lose a finger or anything. He tends to be chopping.
I was going to say that. The knife, not a good thing to be jumping out killing fellas with knives.
No. Is it true that every time William hears his name now he jumps?
Oh, fully. Yeah.
Does he?
Fully. Yeah.
That's good.
Like every time I enter the house, he jumps.
Rodge! Oh, Jesus!
Rodge!
All right, Grant.
I love that shit. It's great.
Yeah.
Come here. You're riding on William's coattails, though, pretending to be a cook now, aren't you?
I can cook.
You can in your home.
You can go.
Look, there's the book now. How much did William have to beg you not to put your face in the cover?
A lot.
Yeah.
I'd say you did. What kind of recipes are in? What's in there now? If we were saying, listen, we were coming over to you lads for dinner and we were going to cook us something from the cookbook, what would you be making us?
Well, we have a ham and cabbage sandwich.
Ah, for God's sake. Look, is it called Currabini? Because most of it's going to end up in the fucking bin. Huh? Honest to God. Jesus Christ, sandwiches. What do you know?
There's a third member of your family. Tell us about Princess Diana Kavanagh.
Princess Diana Kavanagh, which I've noticed is a photo over here of her. Oh, Isn't she beautiful?
Yeah, but so there's something wrong there with her. She's got the mange. What happened to fur?
She's a sphinx, so she doesn't have any fur.
Ah, no, hang on. No. I got it. Look, have a look at this.
We know what happened.
We know what happened.
Cruella de Kavanagh.
Yeah. There you are, that poor cat. Ended up on your
my
back.
My sphinx cat.
Yeah.
How many followers does the cat have? Because she's got her own account
and
everything.
12,000 at the moment.
What the fuck?
Yeah, she's Ireland's most followed cat. Yeah.
Come here, you're apparently, right, famous for being a bit of a style icon.
I would agree.
We would beg to differ. Can you talk us through some of your outfits now? What the hell is that all
that's
about?
A kimono. Kimonos are fab.
What's the thing at the
that
front?
That was me in Thailand with my bum bag. Or a fanny pack.
That's a very, very large fanny pack.
Yeah. Come on, that's a fanny.
What the hell now?
That's Mrs. Diana in my little bag that I carry her around in.
It has a washing machine.
It's kind of like a little washing machine. But I bring her around town and she can kind of look at what's going on.
And is that style?
That's style. Absolutely.
Let's have a look at another one now.
What's going on there?
Forget to take the plastic off the dry cleaning.
That's my plastic Balenciaga shirt.
What the hell, fashion.
I swear.
That's an actual shirt,
That's actual fashion I paid for, yeah.
Jesus, I don't know. I paid for that.
We thought we'd test you, right, to see if you even know what stuff is yours and what's not.
Okay, I'm
in,
up for it.
In a little game we've entitled Kavanaugh or Kavanier. You ready to play?
Go for it.
Is this a Kavanaugh or a Kavanier?
That's a Kavanaugh. That's not me. Oh, that's James Patrice.
Oh, it's James Patrice.
No, it's not
oh,
me.
Oh, is that not you? No.
That's
all
not
right.
Me.
Well, that's, oh, that's the game.
That's the other social media man, James.
Oh, OK. Well, look, yeah. James.
We'll
okay,
try another right, one now.
Try
hold
another
on.
One.
Kavanaugh or Kavanaugh?
That is not Kavanaugh. That's not me. That's Kavanaugh.
Oh, it's your man again. Cuddy's very, very popular, isn't he?
He kind of wears that well.
I see what's going on.
Well, let's have a look at another one. Kavanaugh or Kavanaugh?
I would wear that, but that is not Kavanaugh.
What?
That is Kavanaugh.
Who's that fella? Oh, it's James. Oh, James.
Oh, my God.
What's going on there?
He gets around that fella.
Well, he does. He wears it well, though. He looks good in it.
Any more? This is... Oh, no, that's you
that's
for
you.
Sure.
That's got to be... Is that
Kavanaugh
your
or Kavanaugh?
That's not me. That's Kavanaugh. That's Kavanaugh. Who is this?
Oh, it's Jesus.
James. Oh, Jesus.
He is everywhere, that fella.
James Patrice fella, what do you make of him?
What do you make of him now?
I love James Patrice.
Oh, do you?
Yeah.
Because we think that he's your deadly rival in Insta-realm. People are forever getting Fair. Mixed up, though, aren't they? The two Jameses. Is that getting your tits, does it? Does it get your tits?
Does it?
That fucking boss.
Yeah, I know, yeah. Come here.
Taking all
come
my
here.
Gigs.
Come here, though, seriously.
If you killed him, right, would you get his followers?
I...
Is that the way it works?
That's how it works.
Is
yeah.
it?
That how
yeah.
it works?
It's like, it's yeah, it's... I'd get all the gigs as well. Yeah.
Oh, gotcha, right. gotcha. Yeah. I like that.
So,
yeah. Now, come here, with the good as a social media personality that comes to bad, how do you deal with the trolls?
Well, I... get bad comments on what I wear sometimes, like what you were saying to me
yeah,
earlier.
Yeah.
Well, I sometimes wear the bad comments. I am. I got a bad comment about one outfit I was wearing, and I got it printed on a T-shirt
you
and
got the,
wore it.
Nice. But you got the,
so
the
I think
comment
you wear your hate.
Wear the hate. I like that.
I like that.
Wear your hate, because then it diffuses the situation, so it's fine.
Gotcha.
Very good, yeah.
Now, own your hate.
Yeah, you wear your hate. I like that. That's
yeah.
a good
what do you do with trolls?
Huh?
What do you do with trolls?
Well, we are trolls.
Yeah.
Yeah, fair.
As we spent the day
the original
doing.
Trolls.
Yeah. Yeah. But like,
are you bloggers
we...
on veils?
No, at least we say it to people's faces. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We're not some bollocks, you know, arsehole 356 on the internet, you know?
True.
That kind of thing.
You're
come
up,
here.
Upfront.
Shouldn't give out my address.
Oh, sorry about that, brother. Sorry, sorry, sorry. Fair play to you. King of the generation of will do anything for a few euro. James Kavanaugh, everyone.
Hey, James. James Kavanaugh. Thanks for coming in, James.
Thank you. Right, Doreen. Let's get the band on. And if they don't play a song we like, we'll shut this mother down.
Damn right.
Oh, I think you'll like this one. It's Shane McGowan's favourite Irish band, Cronin, with the Dexys classic, Come On Eileen.
Oh.
Rocked out that hard in I don't know how long. Can they be our new house band?
Listen, they'd steal the feckin' lead off the roof of your joke and lock the drinks cabinet.
That's right.
Well, that's it for this week. Join us next week when we'll be welcoming 1/5 of Girls Aloud, Nadine Coyle.
Oh, now what passport is she travelling on, huh?
And Bisto-faced Big Brother star Huey Mahon.
Huey Mahooey?
Dancing with the Stars.
Oh!
The honcho with the tan.
Oh, the fella with the tan.
Oh, the African fella, right.
Gotcha, yeah, gotcha.
Good night.
Night, night, night. Night. See ya.
Good night.
Oh, yeah, I'm exhausted. Come on, Eileen. Come on, Eileen. Very good tone of letting me down, though.